Right, time to at least go for a while of Darkest Dungeon again, and as some may remember from last time, we first have to deal with the brigand attack up in the hamlet, so let's try to at least consider what would be the best approach, as the issue of course is that the brigand chief has bombs and we need to be able to reliably destroy the bomb guard before he at least throws too many of them and or heal sufficiently to be able to deal with the bomb damage in the order of like 20s. So let's examine the overall things we have for use. One is clearly the shield breaker, as they have the ability to attack any position with the so most probably we should get rid of the blight ability here and include the puncture, as it can pull uncertain then whether the pump card is also immune to being pulled, but it's at least an interesting try. Also here we have the pull ability, so most probably not taking the abomination as it's kind of favorite. So let's see, in turn here we should most probably also improve abilities a bit. At least also funny to add the ability to do the mining pick. Another matter how useful it is, but it kind of gives more frontal combat ability in this case. The Shadow Fade isn't necessarily very useful, it's mostly for going backwards. Ah, hello Kamu, great to see you. And of course, welcome to the stream. Hopefully you had a good day also today with the holiday season going on. Alright, let's also see, like, the healing abilities are of course most important here. We probably can't dazzle the bomb card, so improving that ability necessarily doesn't bring us much advance. Could probably sell some trinkets. And see if we can improve the overall equipment, especially for the healer, as it's only up to level 3. There we go. Could be also useful to considered a fighter. So let's try and go for it. Most probably would try this kind of arrangement for the brigand. Very good to hear that your day was relaxing. Also, again, there was enough snow that could go skiing for about 4.5 kilometers, and otherwise been searching also parts for building a front panel replacement for PDP 11 backplane that do have here, so been looking a bit again at trying to get the PDP also working. So the day has been pretty nice for vacation, would say. In this case also. Alright, let's go with this and see whatever happens. Would be still nice to get rid of the brigand chief, but it's kind of, they have bombs, and it's pretty much the main issue at all with them. They have bombs. Kind of unsure if we really need like anti-venom or bandages are nice, and shovels. Food we already have like 10. It's the kind of, is it going to be a major issue with food? Most probably not. So in that respect would say that let's go with these items. It's not going to be a matter of who runs out of torches first, most probably. Last time we just had to sacrifice one player character to stop them, and it's very possible again. So not taking the Abomination being favorite one. Indeed, not ridiculous amounts of snow, you are quite right in that respect, that it has been sufficiently moderate that it remains manageable compared to the amount of snow at times. It was amusing once in Canada or such, they actually had to close a ski resort due to too much snow, because they got so much snow that they couldn't guard it out quickly enough to keep, for example, the ski lifts above the snow level sufficiently to operate them. So it's possible to have too much snow in some cases, even for snow-oriented or even dependent business. So in that respect, yes. And now we try to the interesting layout, so let's take the right turn. And first fight. Alright, cannot be hit by attacks targeting only this slot. Throw dagger start it then.
Gains purchase, spirits are lifted, and purpose.
We have exposed. That doesn't apparently help either. Alright, let's test. We can attack any slot, yes. Because that's important for the bomb card.
Grievous
out. That's why we have healer mostly for healing. Right, let's throw more daggers. And now probably impale would give pretty nice. Nice two deaths, yes. That went well. Then heal everyone. That was nice, critical healing even. Though not the right one, but right. These brigands are pretty done with. These have really nice treasures, but it's kind of, are we like getting back the stolen items from our own hamlet, or it's kind of not totally logical, like they are raiding our hamlet and we get treasure for defeating them. Is it already the items we already had? But the game is not totally logical here. And if you noticed, Camu actually found also more ornaments. There are now nice tiger patterned festive ornaments also in the her setup of the overlay. Alright, and then we move on. This is why we bring shovels.
The way is lit. The path is clear. We require only the strength to follow it.
Alright, let's check the tent. Nothing left. Sometimes you find treasure also in those, which is nice. Right, another fight. Right, that removed. Obliterated the rapid canine. Again, do mass heal. Let's move forward. Dodge, good. More daggers, maybe. Oh, they also dodge, so. Kind of even. Can heal everyone. Fortunately, it costs nothing to heal every time, even. Let's poke at the gunman. If he gets you here. Right, that's close. Oh, dodge. This will get rid of the gunman, yes. Thirteen should be, yeah, quite close. Let's heal here. 12 could be enough. Still dodged, alright. Not very good dice. Now get rid of the madman. Yes, now we only have the fighter. Alright. A lot of damage at least.
Impressive.
24. 1 HP left. Alright. Again. Heal there especially. Finished him. There we go. Again, a big amount of treasure, but it's kind of like Are we getting our own treasure back, or? And good to go. Scouting, thank you, Kamu. At least some type of scouting. So let's move in the circle. We will sooner or later probably find the ever pleasant brigand chief in any case. And more rubble. Right, another fight with the big guy, but only, or like more or less. Let's try flight the big guy. Quakes. And dazzle them.
Continue the onslaught. Destroy them all.
Let's keep going at that. Right, let's remove the gunman. And that removes the big guy. Have been good to heal.
Be wary.
Heal in the meantime. So let's use some food. There we go. Now we have more inventory space. Be nice to have even more inventory space. There we go. At least the treasure is very nice. All right, and keep moving. Yes, here we have Mr. I have bombs. And immediately throw a bomb. Thank you. Let's try and get rid of the bomb guard. But heal everyone currently. Right. Gets us almost rid of the bomb guard. Move forward here only. Only 42 damage, so.
Teetering on the brink, facing the abyss.
Rid of the bomb card for a while, like, let's poison it. Would be nice to heal the healer as soon as possible. Right. Not the best move ever, but with the bombs, have to do something. Currently has no bombs. So let's start poisoning the leader here. Can't do much about the bomb, so let's just keep poisoning him. We have the bomb there. Let's just heal everyone. Stopped bleeding, so can't use a bandit. Oh well. Also 10 damage from the light. 68. That was a good bump.
Now the true test. Hold fast or expire.
Heal.
Ringing ears.
22. All right.
The end approaches.
Didn't hear it or something as smart. Let's try to attack the pump card more consistently again.
Despondence.
Not doing very well health-wise.
Or cowardice.
Right. Good attack. Let's heal self anyway.
Death denied. For now.
Then the bomb. Usual.
At the very precipice of oblivion.
Would be nice if it got a turn for the healer.
Precision and power.
dead store or not store. And including the bomb. Right. Heal everyone. Doesn't matter much if everyone is a dead store, because everyone is healed. Actually, at this rate, he is going to die. 37 left. To try to also destroy the bomb card, but it's like secondary.
As life ebbs, terrible vistas of emptiness reveal themselves. Devastating blow.
Because he has only 15 health left, it's theoretically possible to win. Now only 5, so this is actually doable. And he's done.
Great is the weapon that cuts on its own. Seize this momentum. Push on to the task's end.
Alright, couple of trinkets, so we are not certainly needing torches anymore. Let's also put some food here. You eat and you are no longer dying. Good. And we actually did beat the brigand. Brigand boss. Unsure if that stops the brigand attacks or do we even get the more difficult one, but that was actually a very nice result. So let's raise a paw to beating the brigand chief and Kamu, yes, located at the usual place in central Finland, still located at home, didn't go anywhere else for the holidays yet. Indeed, will be nice to see you also, just reserved earlier today tickets to travel over for the New Year's. Alright, that was actually really difficult fight, the bomb man, but we did it and actually it gives kind of a special trophy, so plus 20 damage versus mark, plus 10 accuracy, plus 5 critical versus size 2, so big guys, so actually that has no debuffs at all, very nice trinket. And also gained level, so the fighter is also now level 6. Wield adventure, so even a positive trait. Alright, slow reflexes, yeah. Alright, minus 10 damage if thoughts above 75. Really light sensitive, not the best trait ever. Demonomania, that's always stylish at least.
Cast out from the civilized world, these men may yet be of use to
us. Right, and more lepers, but we currently have a good amount of repelled the brigand raiders, indeed, and even beat the Brigand Chief, so that was actually really successful. We just now need to put all the especially born guys for some stress reduction, so mostly the healer and the then probably put the shield breaker into monastery, so that pretty much takes care of that part. And then we have not the best financial situation ever, as we did some upgrades in respect to that, so let's sell some see if the abomination already has a restraining padlock. Yes. Did we have another abomination? Currently not, so currently not needed. Then we have the plus 10% max HP. Could sell that. Also, this is kind of not very. The kind of basic bonus ones are not very interesting. And now we do pretty much have enough to do another embarkment. Is Kamu going to sleep or? Alright, good night for you and thanks for joining us when we defeated the Brigand Chief. Good night. Let's then see about embarking again. Especially the low level guys could probably use some more practice pretty soon. Short apprentice level looks good. Probably would have the bounty hunter. And the Chester. To use a low level healer and then need someone for the front fighting position, so would probably go for the Hellion. Let's go with this selection and do the apprentice level quest in the ruins to start with. Free food. Actually, the granary seems to work pretty well, that we get some free food, which saves us a bit. 16 should be rather enough for short quest. Couple of keys is always good if we happen to find something we can actually open. Right, that should be sufficient provision.
Pace out the halls right. Of your lineage once familiar.
Start.
Now, Boren.
So how has Ragabash holiday season been this far? Right, scouting. Good. Let's do the separate room first, as we need to explore 90% of rooms, so not leave fight undone. Surprise! Unsure how to use surprise under. Surprise.
Be gone.
Right, that was sufficient. 14. Then missed. Good. Again, the weird result that the undead can't bleed until they are corpse of a skeleton, and then they become capable of bleeding. In whatever way that occurs. Right, what's this again? Yeah, Altar of Light. Alright, some positive trait. And room battle. Right, good. Even two crossbowmen, so have to at least try to do something about them. Right, 9 was sufficient. Finish him might be still a bit early for, let's see, try anyway. 8 is already good. It consistently reduces health. Alright, missed. Bit of damage, but not bad. Two only, so not quite still. Let's see if judgment does the trick, yes.
Continue the onslaught. Destroy them all.
11. Right. Need to heal there, certainly. above everyone else. Do not really have the possibility to attack because the middle is all together. Alright, heal. That was nice, at least helps a bit with the morale.
Press this advantage.
Now we have only the crossbowmen, so let's get rid of the corpses. There we go. We can only buff everyone. There is no attack in the middle. Can only attack the middle with the Chester, so it's kind of like he's not very useful anymore when you have nothing to attack in the middle.
Foolish horrors.
Holy fountain, alright. And of course, being the noble heroes we are, we always steal the coins from the holy fountain. Alright. That sounds still pretty good for a fox, like eating and sleeping, so activity at least, hopefully in a relaxing sense. Alright, then we get to backtrack a little. A trap here. Yes, let's try and disarm. Good luck with the dice, actually disarmed it. Alright, and
a fortune.
More shovels.
Waiting to be spent.
Useful if there are more obstacles. A couple of times have run out of shovels recently and been digging by hand, which is really damaging for the morale. Right, let's do this part first. A bit less to backtrack in the optimal case. Apparently again got some positive traits, so it's at least better. Instead of always finding the altar that summons the Eldritch Horror, you for once find the altar that gives positive traits, like not common in this game. Right, we have food to burn, exactly for that reason. Empty room, so then we again backtrack a little. Then we should have one curio, yeah. Usually nothing good happens with the Iron Maiden, so do not check it unless feeling adventurous. Right, empty room. Trap.
Mind that such missteps are the exception, and not the rule.
Improve illumination. Empty room, and then let's go up first, and then down. Better than a trap, yes, but Apparently the backpack is never trapped. Not touching that. Should be a more senior team to try and fight that horror. Quest complete, but going to certainly check also the last room. Which usually tends to have the luck that then you certainly get the collector. Or some other fun thing, like thing from the stars. Unsure if it's even a good idea to state their names, but... Alright, and again. Alright, you might... Stash loot for once. Littering we luck gold, out with the Iron Maiden. And baubles,
paid for in blood.
Surprise them. Increase illumination. Right, that should be more one sort of damage. And let's remove another one. Here.
The shifted corridors and sloped walls of our ancestry are beginning to feel familiar.
Alright, the base reward again had pretty basic crusader item, some heirlooms. Meditate for stress relief, that's still acceptable. Robust, that's actually better.
The man is slave to the beast, and the beast is slave to
the man. Idle abominations gain one resolve level. And it is during such lunar phases that many residents report shrieks and howls of the most profoundly unnerving quality. Nice. Like extra bonus mostly if you leave the abomination to town. Alright, let's do at least one or two missions more. Right, these were like really good at drinking. Pretty much everyone is now missing, so clearly professional drinkers, don't you say? Our good adventurers. Right, so we should, as necessary, reduce stress. There we go. Do more with the average level. So we have enough funds also. Complete 100% of room battles long. That could be pretty good to finish today, so let's see about stress wise. That's no problem. Only the healer has some stress, but it's not really up to a problem, so could think about, like, we have also a higher level healer, so let's go for her. And also has pretty much the same abilities, so let's go with the same team for long quest, complete 100% of room battles. Right. Two firewoods. Now we need a bit more, like 24 food plus something is a good start. Four shovels. Six anti-venom bandages. Four keys, so we can manage. And would say that at least three full piles of torches is nice, and let's take a few more. Now we can use the consumables and gain inventory slots as we go.
The fiends must be driven back. And what better place to begin than the seat of our noble line?
Right, so let's get going. Pretty big dungeon for a long quest. Always check the ashes. Alright.
Finding the stuff is
found
only
treasure.
The first test.
It's always good to check the wounds with ashes. So of course dead people most probably had money. Right, and these can bleed, so it's even useful to do this, unlike the undead who persistently refuse to bleed. Alright, that was quick. Ten from judgment, pretty strong. Eight, bad. Dodged Elpid's full good accusation. Horror, alright, what can you do? Go for these two again. Already 4 damage from bleeding. Dodge the accusation. Let's try and finish him. Oh, missed.
Slowly.
Bled out.
This is how a life is taken.
Dodged Eldritch push. Alright, judgment works.
Give them no quarter.
Now we just need to get rid of the madman. Preferably use a bandage. Alright, 15 is certainly enough.
Seize this momentum. Push on to the task's end.
Alright, we do not really care that much for the blight charm. It can be sold for some funds. Better than medicinal herbs, and then we have the emerald is actually worth something, so let's get rid of citrine and prefer the emerald. 25 gold isn't really very meaningful.
Ambushed by foul invention.
Right, let's put a bit of food here in the room. Alright, another fight. That certainly finished them. Let's buff everyone.
Let's
remove one sort of damage. Eight from judgment, not bad either. Again, to buff everyone. Nine, all right. Right, 14 from judgment. That certainly finished the acolyte off. That finishes the fight. Falls,
a faint hope blossoms.
Right, would be good to have one inventory slot for gold. There we go. Let's do this side first, as we need to complete 100% of room battles. We don't know where ever we need to be. Right. Five, not quite enough. Like one HP. Right, that removes one altogether, even corpse annihilated. So now we can actually get rid of the...
Their formation is broken.
There we go,
the
only one fighter left. Fortunately resisted bleeding. Mostly again useful to buff, because we can't really attack frontman with the chester, so it's kind of often the chester then just right, that was wrong judgment. The healer is also often pretty powerful if they have the judgment ability. Right, we have more food. Let's use it in situ. 500 gold. Agility talon, bounty hunter. Let's see if our bounty hunter could use a trinket, yes. Immediately into use. No need for inventory slots then. Map, right. Now we know if there are room fights. At least for a bit, yes. There is one, so we need to go there in any case. Right, let's check. Dull and uninteresting volumes from the bookshelf. Right. That removes one. That also removes one.
Confidence surges as the enemy crumbles.
Only the shoot is left, so let's see what we can do about them. First have to hack at some corpses, there we go, now we can attack them more freely. Free damage though, undead can bleed. Six, not too bad. Try judgment, quite. Finish him. And finished him.
Foolish horrors.
brought low and driven the heirlooms to blood. Would be somewhat nice to have along. So let's use a couple of torches and take the crests. Locked sarcophagus. We have a key. That was valuable contents. At least a couple of heirlooms, but yeah, like two busts. Not even taking those, as this can be sold for money, unlike bust, it's just the heirloom. Or scouting, great, so you know, one room more, like at least the next two rooms have no room battle, but as we do not know all of them, we still have to go through. Alright, just noticed the trap and walked into it. Damage was very limited though, it seems. Sometimes. Alright, and the locked display case, we have a key. More gold and two deeds. The deeds are more valuable than the trinket.
In radiance, may we find victory.
Right, maggots. See what we can do about them.
Another one falls.
At least get rid of one. Get rid of another. Suckman gets rid of one, yes. One left. Resisted disease, at least. So now he can only pass here.
Inspiration and improvement.
Right. 23 is certainly sufficient, damn it.
As victories mount, so too will resistance.
Next room, we know this is empty. We have food to burn. Disarm, yes. Let's check the crate. Right, again two busts, not even taking them along. Kind of early to start carrying minor heirlooms in the inventory. Empty room. Scouting, good, now we know if we need to go further. Yes, there's a room battle. So, on we go. Fight. Right, two maggots and one spider. The worst ones ever. Get rid of spider by judgment. And remove one. Remove another. That was not too difficult.
Success so clearly in view.
We would need more inventory space for gold. It's the kind of at which point. Not enough gold to warrant. Yet opening a spot for the pile. Always check ashes. Alright, resisted. Right, empty. And room battle. Less useful against undead, but it is what it is.
Alright.
Obliterated. Oh, missed. Right, that removes threat on morale. $775 gold. That is worth making a spot. We really need to camp less already, so let's carry more gold. Sarcophagus not blocked, so contemplates mortality. Alright. Oh well. Not always helpful to contemplate mortality. And the last room has no room fight, so let's backtrack a lot. A long backtrack. What can you do? Hunger, so we still had spare food. Still a couple of rooms to go.
The match is struck. A blazing star is born.
There we go. To continue. And move downwards. And again hunger. Fortunately we brought food. This is exactly the randomness there that you actually might have to put a lot of food into, just all the time struggling with random hunger event for 3 times already this dungeon, so that's kind of shame, but it is what it is. This room has no room fight despite the nice piles of skulls, so further we go. Crap, alright. Let's see what the crate contains. Some heirlooms.
As the light gains purchase, spirits are lifted and purpose is made clear.
Let's see if there's a fight. Yes. Not quite finished the other. 1 HP remaining. Alright, and stress effect for one courageous, so for one stress effect that is positive. Not common. And our Hellion is without stress at all. resisted getting pushed. Good. Right, that removed another sort of damage. Right, again with judgment. Alright, only the fighter remains now. That should finish the fight, yes.
This expedition at least more keys,
and this takes a key, so let's of course use one for the extra compartment.
Wealth beyond measure.
Pretty good heirloom.
The brave and the foolhardy alike.
Not going to camp even once, so get rid of the firewood. Right. Next room. So there's a room battle. And of course there's also a battle in the corridor now. Right, the spiders are quick. Quick go. Dodged, good. Dodged again, good. Oh, dodged also. Not so good. Right, that removed one. That removed another. That probably bleeds out. We can only buff here. Right, not even bled out. Act out. 21 damage, that was at least convincing.
A trifling victory.
Good pressure that it fits the earlier ones. Alright, and history of sin, too much to bear. Oh well, fortunately was stress-free until then, so not as much an issue. Room. This was empty. There should be a room battle. See if there are more room battles after this. Right, trap. Again hunger. At this rate we couldn't have camped anyway because we have gotten so many random hunger events. Alright, accident during experiment. Resisted flight. Good. And room battle. Not very strong, but need to get rid of these two soonish, preferably. They mostly affect morale. Some extra damage is always good. We finish him. Right, finished them. Expected to also finish the others. These are not very durable. Durable, so it's like also just attacking enough. Good. Alright, quite a bit of morale damage. Judgment. Right, that removes that source moral damage, and probably this finishes the fight, yes.
These nightmarish creatures can be felled. They can
right,
be
right, could use more space for gold. We have only few rooms remaining, so we can get rid
the
of some torches.
We require only the strength to follow it.
Let's see if we find more treasure with the key. Extra compartment. Stone Foley healing, plus 25 healing skills. Did we have space for a trinket? Not yet. Let's replace 375 gold in the inventory. Speedstone and actually put this into use. Right, we still have rooms with room battle. Like down there, so let's move there. As usual, our good jester wants to check the stashed loot. 75 gold, impressive. Right, we still have shovels, which is good. Sometimes throw shovels away and then we immediately encounter obstacles. Right, big guy. Be nice to get rid of the shooter already of anyone. Only 3 hits sufficient for the big guy also for starters. Fast judgment on the big guy and not quite like what 2 or 3. One health remaining. Not so big guy anymore. Missed good. This should actually, yes, this removes the big guy from the game.
Unless inordinate exsanguination be considered a virtue.
Remove the corpse. Not quite even that big a corpse has quite a few hit points apparently. Dodge partially good. One source of damage again. Now we can deal with the gunman next. Right. Dodge again partially. 16 is enough for sure. Not really good enough treasure to waste inventory space. Another room battle. Surprise them again. Judgment helped a bit. 11, good start, removing them from the battlefield. And removed. So we have slightly lesser judgment set, like 12 damage.
The end approaches. Of skill and purpose.
Right, let's heal everyone.
The wounds of war
should
can
put
be
us back a bit on the health
never hidden
situation. Missed all. Alright, there we go. Then we have the 2 crossbow shooter. 11, alright. Dodge to put. Can heal everyone. Right, remove corpse. and another one gone out of the way. Again, make space. Let's heal more effectively. That concludes the fight. See if we still have more room fights to go. Right, some more health with food and scouting, so we right. So that room has to have a room battle. So we need to get there. No more food left,
to
even
fall for such
six
a little
damage,
thing.
Not good.
A bite of bread.
Can't do much about that without food. The very last room of the vault dungeon then has a room battle. Yes. Check books. Most unsettling passage. Very good. Alright, and here's the corridor battle. And some light. And these can flee, so let's make them flee. Alright, now we get to start to heal up again. One. Not quite another, but close. Right. One out. Can get. Potentially could get rid, but another healing turn. Alright, they bled out, so no healing turn. Last room battle for tonight also. Surprised them good. That's useful against undead for 3 damage. 3 damage. 7, all right. Yeah, 7, still quite enough. Still here. 11, good enough. 10, lose morale, but it doesn't matter too much in the final fight here. All right, self is supposed to be.
At any cost.
Again, would be good to heal. I have no food, so there's no death alternative. Dodged good. Alright, get rid of that. 16 was enough. Sure. Heal still again. Alright, that should do the trick. Critical healing up to full. Alright, remove one. movement that removes again one opponent. That's one. There we go. Now we can throw such useless things as torches and keys away. And let's return to Hamlet.
More bones return to rest. Devils remanded to their abyss.
Could be some treasure. For sure. 8,730 plus the 7.5 base. Pretty good amount of heirlooms also, so a good quest to finish the day with. Also improved level-wise a bit, so... Warrior of Light, alright. Baron's Tactician. Plus 20% stress if thoughts below 26. Alright, afraid of the dark. Fear of the dark, one might even say.
Perhaps things are not as bad as they seem.
Plus 200% stress. Stress heal received, so it's again the one good week when there's actually nice light in the hamlet. That's always a good week to finish with. So let's finish for today. And as it seems to be pretty holidayish, not many are streaming and a bit more silent also. Otherwise, thank you for joining. Wish a good night. I'm not going to raid tonight, but rather wish a good peaceful Christmas night and see you tomorrow. Thank you for joining for some dungeoneering tonight.